Gente que enxerga nas encrencas do dia a dia oportunidade de negócios.
Algumas empresas se especializaram em oferecer a boa e velha mão de obra de sempre, só que de roupa nova.
Gente que ensina a ver onde as oportunidades estão.
Um concurso anual escolhe o melhor projeto. O vencedor ganha um cheque de $20,000 e consultoria para montar a empresa.
All you need is a dream and hard work.
E já que é para trabalhar duro, o resultado tem que estar à altura.
Estamos inaugurando agora em julho 10 unidades em Bogotá, na Colômbia, e caminhamos também para uma expansão para os Estados Unidos.
Bem-vindo, você está no Mundo S.A.
Olá, Remy! Olá, Remy!
Uma família formada por um pai judeu iraniano e uma mãe mexicana. Uma mistura peculiar. O fruto é Sara Farzan. Atirada, decidida, Sara cresceu falando espanhol, inglês, hebraico e farsi, o idioma persa. Veio para Nova York em busca de um novo rumo profissional e acabou encontrando em casa a oportunidade que buscava.
I always used to kind of hang out with my nieces and play games and counting colors, numbers and Spanish and Farsi, and it was a lot of fun. And then sometimes their friends would come over and we'd play like many kids together doing these games. And I thought like, oh, this is kind of cool. It's fun. Could be an interesting way to make money, you know? So I went with them once to this class in English, just a music class for children. And the kids were, you know, it was like 15, 20 kids in a room and a girl there singing in English. And everybody was really happy. The vibe was very up. And I thought, wow, like if you put language here, then it becomes educational entertainment, not just happy fun times in English. So I thought, you know, I'm going to try this. If you rent the space for this much and, you know, you charge this much, there's, you know, times it by 15 and you probably rent, you know, pay the teacher a little bit of money, you could make a good profit. So I made a bunch of flyers and I went to the park every day and I passed them out and I talked to moms. And the first day, one kid showed up.
O negócio de aulas de idiomas musicados para crianças até 4 anos nasceu em 2007.
Olá, sol! Olá, sol! Olá, sol! Olá! Bem-vinda!
Hoje, a Bilingual Birdies tem 2 mil alunos em 50 lugares diferentes da cidade. Emprega 23 professores. Sara e duas colaboradoras administram.
I think when I started 4 years ago, we were very much, it was a little niche, but as we've grown, we've gotten bigger, people have caught on to a few of our little secrets, and there are, I think, maybe 2 or 3 competitors now who are doing the same thing that we are, maybe in different areas, but yeah.
What is the difference that you have that they don't?
A lot of language programs, if they incorporate music, they don't have a live performer. And so that is one thing that we offer. We're also in preschools. A lot of our competitors are not specifically in schools. We are doing an online teacher training, so that's another part of the business that I don't think.
Mi amigo, ¿cómo te llamas?
No início, a empresa dava prejuízo.
I started this business with money that I saved up from working 2 different jobs at the same time. And I quickly used all that money because in the beginning I wasn't making a profit. I was losing money actually.
Foi quando encontrou a NIFT, uma ONG especializada em empreendedorismo para jovens, principalmente aqueles de comunidades de baixa renda nos Estados Unidos e ao redor do mundo. É uma ONG mais lucrativa. Registrou pouco mais de $200,000 de lucro no ano passado.
Criada há 25 anos, a NIFT, a rede de ensinar empreendedorismo, conta com o apoio de grandes empresas, como Mastercard, Ernst Young e Microsoft. Marcas consagradas que ajudam jovens de baixa renda a buscar um futuro melhor. Um concurso anual escolhe o melhor projeto. O vencedor ganha um cheque de $20,000 e consultoria para montar a empresa.
Sara foi uma das 4 mil jovens de todo o país a participar do concurso. O desafio é montar um plano de negócios de 5 anos, estudar a concorrência, viabilizar a produção, identificar o público-alvo e fixar a margem de lucro. São várias etapas até a disputa final.
My return on investment is
64,325%.
A cada uma, os jovens precisam convencer os juízes de que a empresa tem possibilidades reais de dar certo. As famílias participam, torcem, os concorrentes tentam driblar o nervosismo. Sara saiu vencedora e o negócio ganhou o fôlego que faltava.
I always say it was the class that I paid the most attention to in my entire life ever. I would go take notes and the next day I would wake up and go and apply the things that I learned in my real life, in my business. So it was a business plan competition. So after 6 months, you had to develop this business plan, a 5-year plan, and I won. Something shifted that I realized, hey, this isn't just like, you know, me teaching, you know, kids some vocabulary words with music. It's actually, I'm going to hire people. I'm going to have more than one class happening at the same time. It's scalable.
Agora, o plano de Sara é expandir o ensino pela internet e oferecer aulas para outros estados e, quem sabe, até para outros países. O fundador da NIFT, Steve Mariotti, era um pequeno empreendedor quando foi assaltado por um jovem em Nova York 30 anos atrás. Como Sara, largou tudo. Foi dar aula de matemática para crianças pobres. Queria impedir que outros meninos entrassem para o mundo do crime. Mas nada de conseguir atrair a atenção dos alunos. Até que...
I just noticed that when they talk about small business and how to make money, that they did better.
500 mil alunos depois, Steve vê o empreendedorismo como o caminho mais curto para acabar com a pobreza.
I think that entrepreneurial education with the concept of ownership linked to it is the biggest breakthrough we've made in youth work from an anti-poverty viewpoint in the last really 50 years. It's a huge breakthrough and it has global implications. There's 75 million young people that are unemployed globally. Many of them have a niche, have a comparative advantage, have unique knowledge that could be easily turned in to a career and a livelihood. You embrace that methodology of looking at life as a series of solutions to problems, and then you lay into it an ownership perspective. How do I put together resources to solve the problem? How can I do this profitably? Because if you don't do it profitably, it's not sustainable.
Os Estados Unidos são um país com tradição de empreender. Foi assim com os primeiros colonizadores e com as ondas de imigrantes que povoaram o país. Mas depois da crise de 2008, o desejo de empreender cresceu ainda mais. A tecnologia teve papel fundamental.
People can test out business opportunities by going to the internet, you know, in about 15 minutes, where it would have taken them, you know, many thousands of dollars and many market research to do it before. And with all of this new technology coming out too, it's showing people how powerful an idea can be.
Amy participou de um painel do Departamento de Educação e percebeu que dinheiro é um assunto considerado tabu nas escolas.
Here in the United States, student loan debt is bigger than credit card debt. Yet, you know, we don't even teach young people what compound interest is before they sign on the dotted line. So this conversation has to start much earlier.
Nesta escola, no centro de Nova York, o assunto é ensinado na sala de aula.
An entrepreneur, you get to do something you truly love to do, something you have created from the ground up. Gives you an opportunity to work for yourself, to create your own hours. And if you're a sole proprietor, all the money comes to you. All you need is a dream and hard work.
Pose de empresário, Ricky já tem. Só falta encontrar investidor para produzir a luva que ele inventou.
My product is a sports glove. Well, it's gloves in different sports dealing with like cold weather, such as football, soccer, and hockey. The glove is just has heat sensors in it to warm your hands up, so it won't affect your play while you're on the field.
O diretor da escola tem certeza de que o ensino médio é o momento ideal para começar as lições de empreendedorismo.
Whether they go into a corporate job or become entrepreneurs right away, their whole careers, they're going to have to develop skills and they're going to have to be able to sell themselves. And so I think the skills they learn through entrepreneurial training will help them their whole careers, no matter what career they follow.
Fui me casar, resolvi reformar um apartamento e aí encontrava essa mão de obra. E aí nós iniciamos a nossa marca com reparos e reformas.